Years ago, on this very day, Channel 7 put to air a new Aussie soap like no other.
Sons and Daughters became one of the most popular series of the early 80s, introducing a melodramatic style of storytelling onto our screens with an all-star cast.
For six seasons, Sons and Daughters was a staple of Australian television.
You love to love them. You love to hate them.
Our answer to Dallas or Dynasty, Sons and Daughters told the stories of two intertwined families as they fought over power, love and money.
How dare she leave all that money to Beryl Palmer and Margaret God?
Iconic Aussie stars filled out the cast. Rowena Wallace, Peter Phelps, Cornelia Francis and Tom Richards, just to name a few.
But I'll tell you what to do. Look, I got you that job with
Dad!
You go back there and apologise.
Dad, it's a lousy job!
Someone's driving a truck all over the country, but it's a job!
All actors who found themselves as part of some of the most dramatic storylines Australian TV had ever seen.
Well, are they sure it's Pat?
I don't want to look like I did before. I want a whole new face.
That's what we said after holidays. I want a whole new face. One of the show's original cast members, Tom Richards, who played David Palmer, joins us now. Hello.
Hello,
Tom.
How are you?
That was you screaming at your son.
That's right. Well, actually, I used to do that with my own son. It just sounded like me.
You'd been on screen for a decade before Sons and Daughters came along.
Yeah, really, yeah, I think it was. I started back in 1972 on Matlock Police.
Wow.
So that was good. That was 4 years.
That was one of my favourite shows, that
was. Was it?
Oh, yeah, yeah, yeah.
Just like The Chase was one of my favourites.
Oh, first
and
one.
This, and Morning
first
Chat.
One. First one. Now, the show introduced us to some of the most memorable TV characters of all time. We're talking Pat the Rat and a whole bunch of others. Did you realise at the time you were making something so very special?
Not at the time. You never do. You know, you're working and you go home, you learn your lines, you come back and people might see you on the street or somewhere. Actually, right now, in this period of time, in the 80s, or in this period of time in the, 2022s, it's getting more popular because the DVDs are out, there's fan clubs, there's about four or five on Facebook.
Is that right?
Yeah, and there's a couple on the internet, so really it is very more popular today, I think, than back in the 80s.
Yeah.
Some of the storylines back then really got Australia talking, but you told New ID recently that you were never worried, despite some of the wacky turns the scripts would take. You didn't mind. That was all part of the fun, I guess.
No, there were some funny things in it and some good things, some dramatic things. You think, my God, can that really happen? But you trust the writers, and they all did a good job. The show was well received. And the thing, good thing about Sons and Daughters is the folks, made a DVD and interviewed one of the fans, and she had all these books, these photos and all that, and she said, really, we just related to us as a working class. The Palmers were a working
class. It was very, very relatable. Yeah. Well documented too, but behind the scenes, the cast and crew were like one big happy family, right?
We were.
Got to tell us about a thing called Tinny Night. What was Tinny Night?
It wasn't actually Tinny Night, but that's a nice word to put in.
Okay.
The real word I can't use on TV, of course, but we have to call it a Willy Night, the Willy Night, the Willy of the Week.
Oh, maybe we don't want to talk about this story.
Oh, well, we can, because there's nothing dramatic about it.
I see.
You may do something good, you may do something bad, and they'll say, oh, yeah, you've got the Willy of the Week. They'll say, Larry, you've got the Willy of the Week.
I've never heard those words.
No, it was a bit different in those days. This was back in the 80s.
so you can say stuff like that then.
Yeah.
Wow.
Yeah, it was fun though.
Wow, what fun you had on.
We had a slab of beer and wine and all that, and you'd get the award.
What was the award for Willy? What did the Willy get?
An award. Actually can't say. You're twisting my arm, Mary.
the prize was some slab of beer.
Oh, it does sound like
that's it. Yeah, it's very good. Yeah, it's very good. Yeah.
I don't know. But let's move on. The show was a huge success, apparently, in Europe.
In Europe, in England, in the Caribbean.
Wow.
I don't know about Mexico. But in Europe it was, in Belgium. We went over there about four or five times on a tour. One of the gentlemen is called a magazine called Dag Allemaal, and he came over here to make a story, took some photos, was so impressed with the whole lot, and arranged for Pat McDonald, Stephen Comey and myself to go over to Belgium. And we thought, this is great fun. And we went to this chap that put some money up, big Mercedes-Benz dealer. And when we got there, there's only about three or four people. And we thought, this is great. And we said to Vicky, the chap that's from the magazine, and he said, oh, it could be different. We went down the road to the gentleman's daughter's boutique, and they were all these people around. We thought, what's that? And he said, I don't know. They were there for us. And the idea was we'd go in, they'd come in, we'd sign. We couldn't get out.
Oh,
everyone was just pushing on the windows, and that just happened. Then Antwerp, 20,000 people stopped us in the cars, and we couldn't move. And
Is that right?
Oh, blew our minds.
What about a reboot? What do you reckon?
I think it'd be good, you know, different cast, get some old folks in there like myself. Yes, like myself.
yeah,
but I think it could work, yeah. Yeah, it's a nice little show, family show, I guess. Yeah.
It was a great show.
And what are you doing with yourself these days?
Well, I do a lot of directing for the local arts theatre.
Yeah.
Thanks for that. Yeah. Doing a play coming up now, and do some casting on the weekend.
Fantastic.
And I've been doing that for the last 8 years.
Great.
And then I had a video production company that I went around the world shooting, filming and directing it.
Fantastic.
With a fishing company. So that was quite good for about 10 or 15 years.
Sounds like I got it all sorted out.
It was.
As well as winning Willy of the Week.
That's right. I think twice.
Twice, well.
I went to Wallace Run a few times.
Good stories. All right, Tom, thank you. Lovely to see you, mate.
Yeah, same here.
Thank
great.
You so
Thanks
much.
A lot.
Great memories.
And
great
you
memories.
Can stream Sons and Daughters for free on 7plus.com.au. That's brought back lots of memories for you, which has.